Let the peace, love, and blessings of Jehovah God and His Christ be upon the entire world. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The source of the universe. Everlasting gospel delivered to the entire world by the Holy Spirit of Truth, leader Olumba Olumba Obu, the supernatural teacher. First lesson, St. John chapter 16, verses 14 to 15. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine, and shall show it unto you. All things that the Father hath are mine. Therefore said I, that he shall take of mine, and shall show it unto you. Second lesson, St. John chapter 3, verse 34. For he whom God hath sent speaketh the words of God, for God giveth not the Spirit by measure unto him. Golden text, John 1, verses 1 to 2. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. Introductory spiritual choruses. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. The Word has become man. He is dwelling with us, and we are in him. Man is God. Quote, brethren, you have a great desire to see God. In St. John's Gospel, God is revealed as love. Our Lord Jesus Christ revealed God as the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And in today's Gospel, John has again informed us that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. You who is seeking God, have you not seen him? When referring to God, we should simply summarize him as Word. The Word consists of everything. The Word is God. It is power and everything by God. The Word had been in existence ever before the foundation of the world was laid. The worldly people erroneously claim that man is not God. And if I may ask, if man is not God, who is man? And who created him? Is it not the Word? Through which medium were man and the Son created? Was it not through the Word? The rain, day and night are products of the Word. The moon is also from the Word. Everything that is in existence, living and non-living, visible and invisible, are all products of the Word. You are now completely free to take your share of the Word. What can we refer to as the Father? He is the Word. The Son and the Holy Spirit are also the Word. Are these three separate entities? How many entities would we say exist in the world? Can any error be identified in the statement made by our Lord Jesus Christ that all what I have are yours and yours are mine? Why do we lack divine knowledge? Truly, nobody has got this recondite knowledge from the era of Adam to the present generation. Brethren, we have now returned to the Garden of Eden. It is certain that we are living as indestructible fold. There is no segregation and distinction of any sort. It would be discovered after a thorough analysis of the system of the world creation that we all are one. One Lord, one Father, one God, and one Master. The entire members of the kingdom should declare that everything created by God is brotherhood. Such deep understanding and declaration would overcome the whole world. The constituents of brotherhood. The gospel titled Brotherhood is carrying out the task. The salient truth is that heaven and earth are brotherhood. The sun, the moon, and star are all brotherhood. Animals in the forest, fishes, trees, wind, earth, rivers, and mountains constitute brotherhood. Would you say that what had existed from the beginning of the world does not constitute brotherhood? What is behind the existence of all these realities? The answer is brotherhood. Why then do you seek to know the origin of brotherhood? For this reason, it is the pleasure of the Father in this chosen time to unveil the truth that everything created by God makes up brotherhood. We have only one Lord, one Father and Master, and His word is indivisible. His injunction is also one. Do not see God in the bedroom, in the forest, in the dream, in the moon, or in the star. At this point in time, you are feeling Him. You are seeing Him and listening to His voice. Nobody should put asunder what God has predestinated to be done. Often, you draw a distinction between a man and a woman. What is the mark of difference between man and woman? Do both of them not emanate? Do both of them not emanate from the Word? Again, what mark of distinction exists between a child and an old man? Are both of them not manifestations of the Word? All we are witnessing now is in accordance with what is written, that the kingdom of this world has become the kingdom of Jehovah God and His Christ, and He shall reign forever. Jehovah God and His Christ is the sum total of everything in existence. He is the head, life, power, the air, plants, ocean, rain, and everything one can think of. The truth about oneness must be known. In many institutions of learning, you find so many workers. Who are these numerous workers? Is it not the Word that performs these works? Who are the buyers and sellers in the market? Are they not the Word? You were enjoined not to harden your heart when you hear His voice. But have you not hardened your heart now that you have heard His voice? As the spiritual chorus reveals, He is on earth performing His work, though the world does not know Him. This is a clear indication that if God does not reveal Himself to anybody, none can know Him. This is the era of His supreme reign on earth. The whole inhabitants of the world are thieves and robbers because they lay claims to things like land, children, and wealth that do not belong to them. What God has put together, nobody should not be put asunder. Nobody should change what God has built. From henceforth, let it be known that we all are one. No more division whatsoever. There is no room for distinction between a European and an African. Such identification existed in the past. There is a local adage that one is good, but two are bad. The moment you strictly adhere to this adage, division would no longer be amongst you. In the beginning, man and God live in unity as one God, one Father, one Son, and Lord. Therefore, you have to desist from seeing yourself as better than others. Eschew criticism, since everything is harmoniously one. Let our first lesson be re-examined. First lesson, John chapter 16, verses 14 to 15. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine, and shall shew it unto you. All things that the Father hath are mine. Therefore, said I, that he shall take of mine, and shall shew it unto you. His words fulfilled. Brethren, is the above text understood? Often you would say that language is different from mine. And the pertinent question is, to whom does the language belong? Does it not belong to the Word? All the voices heard belong to Him, and He does every task or assignment. The text above explains the statement made by our Lord Jesus Christ that, I have yet many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. But when the Spirit of truth shall come, He will lead you into the truth. He shall glorify me, for everything that belongs to the Father belongs to me. This is the time of His glory. All the words heard come from Him. All the words heard in the past and to be heard in the future emanate from Him. I strongly believe that our problems would be over if we would believe that all the sounds and words come from God. The testimony by the information secretary, Christ servant Ayo Okon, about a woman who resides in Aba state of Nigeria, confirms this truth. According to him, the woman was dealing in bread, and it happened that one day while she was returning from the farm, she saw a madman who warned her not to eat the bread, otherwise she would have herself to blame. Many of you consider those who loiter about as senseless people, and whatever they say is regarded as nonsense. But this woman adhered to the instruction from the madman. The moment she got home, the devil's child appeared with a loaf of bread meant for her. And immediately, the madman's warning flashed through her mind. When she tore open the bread, she discovered a poisonous substance in it. You would not have problem if only you listen to the word, whether it is in the form of lyrics of a song or vision. You should adhere to it, since it comes from God. The moment you believe that the word was in the beginning and through it everything was made, you are saved automatically. You were advised not to harden your heart whenever you hear His voice, as did your fathers, and they perished. Therefore, Let us believe in all his words, abide by his words, and carry out all his divine instructions as he directs. We should not bother to rephrase these words, since we know that they came from God. According to the testimony of Deaconess Aprilia Clement, the Holy Father infused life into her in the spiritual realms. Otherwise, she would have been transferred. This truly manifested in physical life. For that reason, you are advised not to toy with the word. We should strictly carry out all his divine instructions. It is said that man was created out of the dust of the earth, after which the Spirit of God was infused into him. From this statement, it means he is dwelling in you, talking to you, and controlling all your affairs. Therefore, you should listen to the word in you. The assurance is that to all that listens to him, he gives abundant peace and life everlasting. This word transforms into trees, into fishes, into money, and into everything seen and unseen. Do not search for God in the air, in the fire, or in the dreams, for he is right here with us. We have to listen to him and walk in accordance with his teachings. He is the doer of all things. What we need to do is abide by his words and stop seeking advices from elsewhere. He does not stop communicating with you at any point in time. The moment you see a man, it follows that you have seen God. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head." This portion of the scriptures gives a better explanation to the fact that he lives in us every moment because he has no alternative dwelling place. He lavishly pours out his words at all times. We should therefore listen to his word and do them, for they are directly from God. Let our second lesson be read again. Second lesson, John chapter 3, verse 34. "For he whom God hath sent speaketh the words of God, for God giveth not the Spirit by measure unto him." The word of God is unlimited. Remember that. It is stated in the scripture that, "Wife, respect your husband, and husband, love your wife." What is the significance of both respect and love? Both are the same thing. Wife, you are advised to respect your husband and love him. And the husband, you should also love and protect his wife. You are enjoined to give her undivided love, no matter what she does. The word is not given by measure. The word is God. It is the first and the last. You must hold firm to the word, because whoever has the word abides in it, for it is not given by measure. Do not say to yourself, "A particular voice is from God and the other is from the devil." The whites can manufacture anything in this world except the word. We are in the kingdom of God, and God is dwelling in us. And so when you speak the word, it transforms into fire or produces wind. By the word, everything is made possible. It is for this reason that you are advised not to allow evil communication to proceed from your mouth, but that which is good should be used for edification, so that it may minister grace to the people. Oftentimes you regret doing a particular thing, although your mind had instructed you not to do so. If I may ask, why did you fail to listen to the directives from your inner mind? The secret is that it was not your mind, but God, that instructed you not to do it. You should at all times listen to the divine instruction whenever he instructs you to desist from doing anything, and you should hurriedly hearken to his instruction whenever he demands you to undertake any assignment. The soul director. From henceforth, do not claim to be the owner or doer of anything. If you present a gift to somebody, it is God who has given, and any gift received is from God. He is behind the manifestation of everything. He is the one who renders prayers. He renders songs, preaches, he teaches, and walks in accordance with his directive in order to attain eternal life for us in due season. According to the spiritual chorus, we are advised not to seek glory, because he who is worthy of glory has come. This is his appointed time, and he has revealed himself everywhere. The word constitutes his tool for the revelation of his divine being across the length and breadth of the world. We are witnesses to the truth that throughout the ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ, he maintained firmly that God is the sole director of all his affairs. He has always maintained that the Father did everything. He acknowledged the Father as the doer of everything. Now that you have the knowledge that he is responsible for all events in the world, it is up to you to abandon self-glorification and give all glory to him alone. Man is the architect of his problems. Man is the architect of his woes. You remain unprogressive because of what you are. You repeatedly speak evil words without the slightest knowledge that these words bounce back at you. You are enjoined to lead a responsible life and always speak good words. You should realize that every word uttered comes back to you. For instance, if we cultivate the habit of saying that everything belongs to the Father and that all that belongs to the Father belongs to us, surely we would have perfect peace and there would be no more problems. You may have heard the story of a young man who was passing through hard times. He had a very rough time. Because of these difficult times, he made up his mind to commit suicide. As he was moving towards the place to hang himself, he saw a fence that separated him from an elderly man. The old man brought out his snuff box, a bottle of gin, and placed them on a chair. He then gently advised the young man not to take his life as a result of hard times. He consoled him that no condition was permanent and that the future could eventually become bright for him. When the young man heard these words of admonition, and although he could not see the speaker, he knew the words were directed at him. When the young man made another move to hang himself, the old man once again took a pinch of his snuff and sipped his gin. He repeated his admonition. When times are hard with you, do not attempt to kill yourself or be disturbed, because as long as there is life, there must be hope. At this point, the young man was convinced that he was the one truly being spoken to. When he finally changed his mind, he returned home. As he carried his pillow, he saw the sixpence he had left, he went to the market with it and bought a hen. It was not long that the hen started laying eggs, and 20 eggs were laid. All the eggs were safely hatched, 20 in number. Thereafter, he sold these chickens, and with the money realized, he started some trading and eventually become prosperous. Later, he built a story building and became rich through his trading. The importance of words. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. Everything was made through the Word. And having known this truth, you are no more expected to say evil words. Whatever you do, make sure it is in conformity with God's divine injunctions. Having known that He is behind every occurrence, you are advised to be careful of what comes out of your mouth. The scriptures have warned that of all evil words uttered by man, they shall be accounted for them on the judgment day. Be very careful of what you say. People are in various precarious states because of their evil utterances. When you wish somebody to be dead, it means you are inviting death to yourself. Conversely, when you wish someone long life, it means you are indirectly asking for long life, and it must come to you as a reward. If you seek good possessions for another person, it follows that you want good possessions to come to you. The boomerang of evil. An illustration. This serves as another illustration to confirm that we should not at any time utter evil words. Once there lived a couple who had a son. One day the son suddenly disappeared and they could not trace his whereabouts. By this time, there were strange stories like the child had been killed, while others said he was still alive. Actually, nobody could precisely tell where the child was. Meanwhile, the child was in an unknown city struggling to earn a living. As he continued to struggle for survival, he became very prosperous and purchased many merchandise. In the end, he was wealthy enough to buy an ownership. He was so wealthy that he wrote his name boldly on the ship. When he decided to return home, he gathered his possessions into the ship and set homewards. He arrived home after an exhausting journey. The ship was at the beach. He proceeded to notify the police stationed at the village of his arrival. From there, he went straight to his father's house with a bag filled with money and other things. At first, the parents did not recognize him. They rather lamented that the fellow looked like their lost child. Brethren, a sad event took place. Some people conspired and murdered the young man. The reason behind the murder was that the parents of the young man often vandalized other people's property. After that, the assassins made a shallow grave, buried the boy, and covered the spot with refuse heap. They thought that was the end. Meanwhile, those who accompanied the young man on his journey were still on board on the ship. At daybreak, when the young man was still not found, His companions decided to report the matter to the police. They remembered that he had told them he was going to see his parents. They later went to his parents and inquired if they had seen the young man who just came back from a distant land. The parents said they have not seen him or heard anything about such a person. The policeman revealed to the couple that the missing man was their lost son, and that if they did any harm to him, they should blame themselves. After a thorough investigation by the police, it was discovered that the couple, out of sheer wickedness, masterminded the killing of the young man, mistakenly regarding him to be another person's son. Little did they know that he was their son. When the hideous act was discovered, the police descended heavily on them, and eventually they were executed by hanging according to the law. Consequently, the government forfeited the whole wealth of the couple. So, beloved, be sure that your utterances are able to yield good results, since you have got the understanding that whatever happens to you is the product of what proceeds from your mouth. Read the golden text once again. Golden text. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. God, the embodiment of all. Do not conceive evil thought, but always listen to your spirit. Brethren, this would constitute your take-home package. Having known that God is the brain behind every occurrence, you should no longer attribute any happening to a demon or necromancy and other diabolism. It is God who gives, and it is God who takes away. We should emulate the good example set by our Lord Jesus Christ, who recognized the Father as the doer of everything. When God sent Ananias to Paul, on getting there, he informed Paul that the same God who appeared to you is the one who has sent me to you. He never glorified himself. Let us do everything as though it is God that is responsible. Whenever you give alms to people, it is the Father who has given and not you. If you receive it, it is also the Father who has received it and not you. If somebody rejects a gift from you, do not feel bad about it, for unknowingly he is rejecting a gift from God. More so, do not feel bothered if anybody rejects your advice, for he is rejecting God's advice. This is the time for the glory of God to be made manifest. Recall the conversation between our Lord Jesus Christ and the Samaritan woman. Our Lord made it clear to her that they worshipped in the mountain and at Jerusalem because they knew not what they worshipped. But we know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. So the time is right to glorify him in everything we do. You should pay attention to him, because if he does not send you on an errand, you cannot go. And if he does not carry out an action, you cannot do anything. Do not add or subtract from the assignment you are sent to carry out. You must have heard the testimony given by a brother recently about what God did for him. He recalled how some time ago he came to the Father because of his dwindling business fortunes, and testified before the Father. The Father made a pronouncement about his request that he has now opened his business. Though the brother had wondered how this pronouncement would manifest, but consequently, as he went back, the Father actually manifested his words. Brethren, you are enjoined not to always make negative statements, but positive and good pronouncements, such as, "Go, your problems are solved." Because it is the Father who does everything, whatever proceeds from my mouth does not come from me, but from God. You are enjoined not to say it is Olumba who preached. Rather say it is the Father who does the preaching, and if you reject the admonition, know that you have rejected the word of God. We must accord him glory in everything. For this reason, he has enjoined us to love one another as he has loved us, and that we all are one. Brethren, I would not be tedious with you. It is said that a stroke of the cane is sufficient for the wise. Let he who has ears to hear, let him hear what the Holy Spirit has imparted to the world. May God bless his holy words. Amen. End of quote. Peace in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, Father.